Yo, I am back. I am going to attempt this again for the fuck. What up, Christina? Let's try this again. Yeah, and it's trying to bring you in. It's trying. There we go. What up?
That's what up? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you playing this day. What is up?
Nothing. How about you?
Yeah, not chill. Like I said, just chilling. You know,
well, anytime you do one of these videos, all you gotta do is come find me. And if I'm not busy, I'll be there because I hate typing.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Right, and I get it entirely. Like, I'm the same way. Like, I would rather, and that's a little fun fact about me, y'all, if y'all don't know, I do like to talk more than I type. Well, it depends on what kind of mood I'm in. Like, if I'm sick or something, then I'll, you know, more or less type. But, like, if I'm up, you know, normal, I usually call somebody, hit them up, be like, yo, what up?
Yeah. Oh, you gotta remind Eric about the ICP shirt.
Oh, trust me, I'm playing too.
And he's gotta autograph it in fluorescent green, like he said.
Oh, he will. Like I said, I've known Eric for fucking years now, so like he knows I'll keep on top of his ass.
I was the female that was in there messing with him about that shirt.
Yeah, I know. I've seen that. That was some funny shit, though. Not even gonna lie. That was pretty damn funny.
I know, right?
You're just like, I want that shirt, damn it.
I got one, but it's too small.
Oh, damn. That sucks.
So I'm going to put it on my wall.
Hey, there you go.
I love me some ICP. Fuck the world.
Right.
I hate everything.
Hey, I'm the same way, so don't feel bad. You ain't the only one. Oh. Invite some motherfuckers up in here.
Get off of the phone.
What's up? Move.
What's the matter, Ryan?
But yeah, what up to everybody watching? I don't know who all is watching because I'm busy adding people like a motherfucker right now. So what up to everybody?
I don't know. It's just me.
Huh.
They'll be in here.
Huh. Usually, that's weird. Usually there's like a lot more people than that in here. Like, that's definitely weird.
Yeah, but it's like Saturday morning. Everybody got tore up last night. They passed out.
Yeah, I know. It's like, what the fuck, people? It's Saturday morning. It's 8 a.m. Y'all should be up, man. Not fucking sleeping in like a bunch of lazy asses. Fuck. Hell, sometimes I'm up at fucking 6 a.m. in the morning. Sometimes earlier than that. All right, showing me live right now, so let's try doing this. That's why I love having both this and a Chromebook. I can switch back and forth. I can share shit and do shit all at the same fucking time.
Yeah. Maybe what you're doing. You want a brownie?
Yeah, give me one.
I ate a part of one. It's just damn.
What's it called?
It's a bottle's of brownie. It's like them Sara Lee cakes that we got. But that's better. That's the only thing the rat didn't get into, I don't think.
Oh, shit. Y'all got rats in your house?
Oh, hell. Let me tell you. I got, look, right here next to me. I got this one. Betty, look, say hello. Oh, God. And there's Peanut.
No.
And give me a few minutes, and I'll show you the rest of my dog.
Hey, you're good.
And I don't know where my cat's gone.
Probably hiding.
Oh, no. She's a bit, look at that. She tried to tear up the dove on top of the tree.
Oh, geez.
How in the hell did she do that? Well, we need to put Papa and Olive back in there. She done knocked him down. Yeah, I still got my Christmas tree up.
Hey, there's a lot of people out there that have their Christmas tree up all year round. That's typical anymore.
Well, after Christmas, I'm going to take it down this time.
Yeah, isn't that what we all say? We say we're going to take it down this time, and then we never do.
Yeah, well, I got a little one. It sits on the table.
Hey, Biker, what's good, my dude?
I'm on that ICP shirt.
Right. That's like the other night, actually last night after the live stream with Eric, like everybody was fucking wanting the goddamn dragon shirt that I had on. I'm like, nah, dude, like this was given to me as a fucking Christmas present. Fuck that. So,
he did his contest the other day, and the first question was, what's his favorite kind of cigarette? You know him, what's his favorite kind of cigarette? What is it?
Weed.
Yeah, I said Mary Jane cigarette.
I know that boy all too fucking well. Like, I've worked with that man for 10 years.
I won the mask.
I'm going to tell you, if he ain't got his weed, he's a pain in the ass sometimes.
He was going to give me a mask.
No offense, man. Just saying. I don't like it.
You know that black mask he wears all the time? Mm-hmm. That's got the black mask,
yeah,
that has the white.
Yeah.
I can't stand masks. I don't like stuff like that.
Right. I mean, I'm not too good at
masks,
but hey, you know, who am I to say, you know?
Well, he told me, I told him, I said, I'm grateful, but I don't, that scares me. I'd rather have a t-shirt.
Right.
And I saw the one, time he was doing one of the skulls on it.
Right.
And I wanted it. And then he had on a red poison one with a skull and a rose. I didn't see the front of it. The orange one with the prison numbers on the front. But then the ICP, I want the ICP.
Right.
I got to have it.
You were all like, I want that shirt, damn it. I want that shirt, damn it.
Uh-uh.
Like, that was good. That was some good shit. I'm just like, what the fuck?
He said, I could get you one just like it and autograph it. Where's it green? Okay, but why don't you just take yours off, autograph it, and get you one?
Exactly. Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
That don't make no sense.
Right. Hey, not too much, Greg. What's going on, man? Hey, brother Anthony Burns. What is up, man? How you doing? If y'all don't know, man, Anthony Burns here, man. If you've not watched his live videos, go do it, man. You guys will definitely get a lot out of them. I know I get a lot out of them. They definitely do help me. So if y'all have not checked out Brother Anthony Burns' stuff, man, go do that shit, man. Go check out his videos, man. He's definitely got some good stuff. Definitely uplifting. You know, they do help a lot of people, including myself. So what's up to Anthony Burns? Much love to you, man. And I can honestly say I have not missed a single live stream he has done yet. I've always watched him. So what's up, Anthony? How you doing, man?
Hey, you're in Ohio, aren't you?
Yeah, I am, actually.
You know Brett Bryant?
I'm not sure.
Hey, they call him Wall Street.
Do what?
They call him Wall Street. He's a rapper, whatever.
I don't think I've heard of him. Like, I know a few guys around here. Like, I know my buddy Matt also goes by the name PFV. He's a local rapper that actually went huge just recently. He's done some shit with Hobson, Tech N9ne, and a few others and stuff. But, like, other than that, I don't really keep track of many people. But I'll definitely check his stuff out for sure.
Yes, he is badass. I got his autographed CD. He sent me two of them.
Oh, nice. That's what's up.
Well, I bought them, but still.
Hey, it works.
The underground. If it wasn't for underground music, we wouldn't have half the shit we got today.
Right. Yeah, exactly. I mean, and not just underground music, music in general. Like, if it wasn't for the old school guys, like, you know, Elvis, you know, Bobby Brown, like all the old school guys, if it wasn't for them, where would we be today? Like, where would we be at today? And that's one thing a lot of people don't do is give credit to, you know, the people that started all the music in general. It's like, you got to respect the guys that
Oh, Brother, Where Art Thou? That's how they started music in a can.
Oh, yeah. Dude, that's actually how I started out, too. Believe it or not, this is actually part of my very first homemade drum kit right here. And I still use it.
Oh, wow, Max, hell yeah.
And I still use it, too. I still use it for a lot of shit.
That's pretty neat.
Hey, you gotta start somewhere. I kid you not, that is what I started out with, a couple colored pencils. That can, a Pringles can on top of the fucking empty baseball bat full of sunflower seeds. Like, that's all I had at the time. So I fucking stuck in between my mattress and my fucking footboard of my bed and kind of went from there and just, yeah.
You're a drummer?
So needless to say, that was pretty much my first ever drum kit. Hey, what up,
drums
Sam?
Are not as easy as they look.
Oh, I know. Trust me. They are not easy.
Imagine having to be the drummer for Def Leppard with one arm. Now, that right there is some shit. That's some talent.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Like, hell, yeah. Imagine having to be the drummer for guys like Suicide Silence, man. The quickness, man. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah, with one arm, by God.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, do you know how the drummer of Def Leppard lost his arm?
Huh, I never did know that.
He was in a car wreck. Nikki Sixx hit him. He was drunk, and he hit him.
Oh, shit. Matt, I got a little something for y'all right here. Shout out to the homie Matt PFV. If y'all don't know, if you guys do know this, post in the comments what y'all think it is.
I have no idea.
Post in the comments if y'all know this.
Long to be gone. It says I'm the only person in here.
Do what?
And they're just watching. They're not even talking.
Right.
So go ahead. Who is it? Who was it?
That was my brother Matt, aka POV with Hobson, and his song, well, actually their song, Homicide.
Do you listen to Lil White?
Yeah, I listen to a little bit of Lil White.
Do you know what his real name is? Patrick Ram something.
I know some of these guys' music. I just don't really pay attention to, like, you know, their actual, you know, name and shit like that. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I met him. He comes to my house acting like a wigger. I said, man, you don't act like it. And he got mad at me. And he got mad. He said, I'll be back. He left and he come back with a CD that he signed, put his name on it, and he threw it at me. I said, what am I supposed to do with this? He said, you'll figure it out. And then when I heard, I was like, oh my God, my favorite song that he sings is Homicidal with Josie Scott from Saliva.
Like, and that's funny because, like, people are always getting, always saying, like, oh, do you really know Matt? Do you really know this guy? And then when I show them my friends list and show them screenshots of me and him talking and shit, they're like, oh my God, like, dude, that's fucking dope. That's so cool. It's like, dude, I went to high school with this guy.
I just got an idiot call me on Facebook. These folks need to leave me alone.
Wow. I hate people like that, man. Like, I fucking hate it.
I ain't never in my life got so many friend requests from random morons. And I was just, this one that I was talking to, I called him before he could ask me for it. I knew what he was up to. Mm. And I said, I want you to be my sugar daddy. And this idiot, oh yeah. And then I told him, I said, I need money to pay my electric bill. And this goofy fucker, he said, well, I can't help you if you can't work. I said, the state pays me to stay home. And then he said, I told him that you were a spam call or something. And I went and I reported his ass. I said, this idiot got butt hurt because I caught him doing what he was going to do when I did it first. Notice I'm still here and he's like,
I fucking love when that shit happens. That's, dude, catching people off guard like that is fucking awesome. Like, you know what they're going to do.
I told him to go get his mama off the street. He got mad. I said, go get your mama off the street corner so she can teach you how to spell.
Oh, shit. Ouch. Damn.
I'm brutal, man. I don't give a damn.
When it comes down to it, you fuck with me or anybody I know, yeah, it's game on, dude. I don't fucking play. It's game on. Like, you want to fuck around? You fuck with the wrong person, dude. You done fucked up.
I know it. I'm the same way. You fuck with my animals. You fuck with my man. You fuck with my daughter. You had a bad day.
Yeah, you definitely got a bad day ahead of you, for sure.
My cup.
That.
I can't get it clean. It's gross.
Hey, y'all, I got a little something for you guys watching right now. Let's see if y'all can name this song right here. And I know a lot of y'all know it. I see you guys in the comments. I know some of y'all got to know this.
Okay.
Hey, Christina, you might know this one, too.
That's ICP. Am I right? I don't have no idea. Sound like ICP.
Do what?
It sounds like ICP.
No. He has worked with him though.
See, I ain't gonna know all that. I know the ones that actually, you know.
All right, how many of y'all want a clue on the song right now? Like, who do you guys think it is? Like, post in the comments if you guys know or you think you know who it might be. I tell you what, man, I'll give y'all a hint. I'll give you, this is going to be, I swear to God, if you guys don't get this hint, you're fucking stupid insane. Let's see, how should I put this? Think strange music.
Eric.
that's what I was about to say too, but nah. But there's literally a record label named Strange Music Entertainment.
I don't know.
All right.
Say not. You want to spray this about her?
Traumatized much from homicide, what? Don't want to flip up, mama, I must be the one that I trust. I ain't got no friend. I ain't got no friend.
Man, I know that voice, but I might be wrong.
You what?
I know that voice, I think. Ludacris?
Close. You're close. It definitely sounds like it, but it's not Luda. I would shoot if that was Ludacris, man. I wouldn't even be sitting here right now. What the fuck? This is crazy. But no, that is actually Tech N9ne.
Ludacris.
Tech N9ne.
Well, Ludacris lives in Atlanta. I live in Georgia.
Oh, no way.
Mm-hmm.
So y'all live pretty close to each other, then. That's what's up.
Well, I'm 45 minutes from Atlanta. Deion Sanders lives here. You have 99.9% of your musicians and your movie stars and your TV people that live in Georgia.
Oh, yeah.
My mom.
Oh, yeah. That's like with, like with our good friend of the family, Bo Bridges, the actor, he actually moved from Atlanta back out to LA just recently with his family and shit. So I'm like, that's what's up.
What was he?
Bo Bridges, actor.
I know who that is. I'm sorry. What the hell? Oh, where my mom and my daughter live at the lake.
Yeah.
They that's where Trisha Yearwood and Jason Aldean grew up.
Oh wow.
My brother fishes with Colt Ford, and I am in love with Brantley Gilbert. So next time they go fishing,
BG on the fucking way. Yes. I fucking love his music all day, every fucking day. Fucking love Brantley Gilbert, man. Straight up. And what up to the BG Nation, guys? We see y'all. What's up?
The BG Nation. Hell yeah. I didn't think y'all knew that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my favorite song by Colt Ford is Chicken and Biscuits.
Oh, hell yeah. Straight the fuck up.
He's making fun of Twilight. I love Twilight, but that shit's funny.
Oh, yeah.
He said, I love my chicken and biscuits. I'm like, what? Man, rip it up.
Hell yeah. Matter of fact, I got a little something for you guys.
Something that I know, man.
Oh, this is something that you know.
Yeah. I turned it out. It was all that black shit. The alien got me in it. What's all that noise outside? Okay. You ever see outside was in there? I'm supposed to take you outside. It might get loud, but just shut up. No,
look what I got. Say hey, Poppy. Say hello. Bet you can't guess what kind of dog he is.
What kind of dog is he?
He's a Staffordshire Terrier. You know, the big pits?
Yeah.
With an English Bulldog.
Oh, wow.
He weighs over 80-something pounds.
Oh, wow. My dog that's here right now, he's actually out with my mom and our roommate getting a new truck. He's actually he's a little tiny-ass Jack Russell Terrier that'll steal your bed if you ain't careful.
Here is Poppy's twin, his little girl and his little boy.
Aw.
And the boy looks just like their mama. She's in the back.
No.
And everybody's worried about my animals. And I have a kitten that belongs to my my emotional support dog.
Yeah.
He's registered.
Oh, wow.
That's Biddy. That's my tweenie.
That's what's up.
My chihuahua got hit by a damn car the other day. We don't know what happened. It hit him in the head. His heart was still beating, and his head was back, and he was breathing. He's always breathed hard, and he's a toy deer head chihuahua. Shush! Hey, baby, put Biddy on you and make him play. That's the baby. They're talking. Oh, roar, 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 roar. There he is. There's a bit bone Biddy. There's a baby. There's a mama flea bitten baby. Ain't he cute?
Oh, yeah. He definitely is, for sure.
His sister was a teacup chihuahua that looked like Peanut, my deer head.
Oh, wow.
She fit literally in a teacup. And she died. The worms got to her too quick because she was so little.
Oh, no.
And he was just a little bit bigger than her. And my pit, my female pit, never had a period, nothing. She was not old enough, but she lactated to feed him and his sister.
Wow, that's crazy.
Mm-hmm. I'll take you this way so you can see her. She's a gorgeous dog.
Hey, what's up?
Get your asses over there. You're coming out.
Get your asses over here.
Peanut dog. There's a peanut dog.
Aw.
I've had him forever.
Right.
Actually, I've had all my dogs, except for the puppies. What are you doing? Come here. Come here. Quit running. Here's my kitty.
Aw.
She's a Seal Point Siamese with blue eyes.
Oh, wow.
Move. No. No. Hey, Pongy girl. She'll eat a motherfucker.
I mentioned it last night in the live stream to you guys that are watching right now. And I do have them. I actually have a couple other things with me that you guys will be able to win in the next contest that I do, which is this noble effort poster right here, 102, which I do have. The other one is actually being posted up. I got this for y'all to win. And as y'all know, I did do some fan art for JDF a while back. And I just happened to get this printed off, and you guys can actually win this piece that I did for him signed. So y'all got the poster, you got the artwork, and you do have a sticker pack coming too. So if y'all want to win any of that, the contest will be set up later today for that. That's just a couple things you guys will be able to win.
Here's my female.
Aw. Dude, she's super happy. She's like, who's that?
No, but she's super violent.
Oh, shit.
She's done, her and Poppy have snapped. She's an Argentine pit. You know, back in the day, when there were slaves in Argentina, they used to
breed Argentine pits.
Oh, yeah.
Because they have one feet, and they can swim and climb and chase the slave.
Oh, yeah.
I don't even want to see it. I don't even want to go in there. I hate this fucking house. Trust me.
Right?
Ugh. It's hell in this bitch.
But y'all, what do y'all up to that are watching? Like, you guys that are watching, like, what are you guys fucking up to?
I try. Man, no!
Come here.
Get your ass in that house.
Come on,
you ain't going back down the street.
Uh-oh.
We're lucky. Uh-oh. Peanut, no. Red, get away from him. Binky, no.
Peanut. Come on, Peanut.
Fucking zoo up in this bitch.
Peanut.
What do you want, you damn son?
Come on, Peanut.
And see, I had the police called on me the other day.
No, Red.
For what?
Because my dog's skinny. And that's because they just got over worms.
Oh, Jesus.
Red, what are you doing? But, the most feistiest one is Binky.
Right.
She's a mess. I might end up with my daughters. And she's already damn pretty big.
Right.
Poppy, what are you doing? Poppy, what are you doing? He ain't paying me no attention. Fuck you too.
Do they ever pay attention?
Hell no.
Didn't think so.
We found out last night. Well, I was texting my son. He wanted to come over here. I said, I'm not your pharmacy, man. I'm not going to keep giving you my meds because I need them. And I said, it's kind of funny. Every time you get a new job, you get sick. I ain't dealing with you no more because I'm a walking pharmacy. I've got boxes and bags full of meds.
Right. I know the feeling. That's how we were when my older brother was sick with cancer and lung cancer and shit. Like, we had a fucking pharmacy in the house. Like, it sucked.
They got me on Thorazine and Depakote.
Oh, Jesus. They had my older brother on, like, before he passed, like, they had him on all kinds of meds. Like, it was insane.
I take anywhere from 15 to 20 pills 4 times a day.
That's about what he was on. There was a pharmacy up in here, like, no joke. Like, it was crazy.
And all these people on Facebook be asking, why don't you work? They pay me to stay home. They don't want me to work.
All right.
Last time I worked, I helped one of my friends out at Waffle House. And this drunk dude kept coming in and changing his order. And then when I was over there fixing the last time, he said, I didn't want it like that, snapping the food and hitting his damn cup with a spoon. I threw that damn plate down and it right in his mouth.
No wonder they don't want to be working their shit.
So I can't damn work no more. I have anger issues.
You ain't the only one. I've been there myself.
We getting y'all some food. Look how it flies. One day we're going to get out here. Water hose. He said, hook it up to the hot water heater. I don't know how the fuck you're supposed to do that. Binky, what do you want? Come on. Come on. Huh? Oh. Red. There's the bink.
Aw.
This is my girl. She's a little off. She ain't normal.
Eh. Are any of us normal? Like, seriously?
Hey, normal people scare me, man.
Thank you.
I barely get along with the voices in my head.
Exactly.
And they always saying, disrupt, destroy, it's eat like, them all. Oh. Say, fuck the world, eat it.
Yup.
Hey, Chase's pretty cool, baby.
It's like, we fuck the world.
That's why I like being on like this, because I cannot stand typing. I got too much to say.
Hey, I'm the same way, so don't feel bad.
Hey, Dave gets mad at me because I've been texting him. And he'll say, don't text me, I'm at work. And I end up texting him another book. Just because I got something to say. Hey, I told you.
Hell yeah.
Uh-oh, Papa's getting skinny.
You know, I think we're going to do a little something. For those of you that are new to live stream, it's something I do all the fucking time. Y'all are about to
I got all that family for you.
What up?
I was telling Dave that me and my mom got a bunch of cornmeal for him because he likes making homemade cornbread.
In 1931, Herman DeVry founded a university
of
patented technology. Today,
what up to all my Disturbed fans, man? This is for y'all.
So what do you have as prizes? I didn't see it. I was in the sun.
Do what?
What are your things you're giving away? I saw the drawing. That's neat as hell.
That was actually Frank's character Bloodshot. He actually plays the character Bloodshot through a company called Valiant. They do like a lot of comic-based stuff.
You know who's in Atlanta?
Jason Ed Frank is actually out of Houston, Texas. He actually lives in Houston, Texas. But this is one of the other ones I'm giving away right here.
That's pretty damn neat. What is it?
It's a
Prisoners of War.
There you go.
That's Palmia. Prisoners of War. That's a pretty neat poster, brother.
Oh, yeah. And the reason why I got it was because I'm actually an Army brat. My dad was actually 82nd Airborne Division. So, yeah, I'm
my
an
dad
Army brat.
Was in the Army.
So, like, every chance I get to, you know, show support for our troops, I'm always doing it.
Hey, baby. We can get Justin to marry us. We won't have to pay nothing.
Anyways, here y'all go, man. This is for all my Disturbed fans out there.
The worshipful master.
Hey, good morning, Crystal. What up? But y'all, this is for all my fucking Disturbed fans out there.
You know what, guys? We need to start making us some live videos because soon. I think we can do it here. And you know, if you get way up there, people actually notice when you start. Well, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about, you know, like you turn the windows or you know. That was just stupid. I watched that video when he was in the car. They said somebody came up the house, but I'm going to go turn the lights on. Now we'll say
But my mama feeling better than thanks to your mama. I'm better than the father. She said, let me alone. I'm not bothering you. I'm better than you can drink. I was wrong. I don't know that. Maybe she's coming back. Put down bread. The puppy is even some pretty good little puppies. They do half past nine. There's babies like it. I don't think they'll be expecting breakfast. I think they'll be might help us out too.
Hey, what up, Steph? What's going on, dude? And hey, happy birthday to you, man. What's up?
Oh, where's your phone? Tell Cecil we happy birthday.
What is going on, Steph? Happy birthday, bro.
What are you telling me happy birthday for? Fuck, he wanted to text me back.
Well, he's probably upset about Howard. I mean, that upset me when I saw it. I was like, what the? I was just messaging him to say hello and then and ask him how he's doing because I ain't seen him go up the road. And then that shit shows up on my news feed. I was like, what in that? Really? And then I actually read it last night when I read it. How the hell did he end up on life for?
Hey, yo, Steph, this one's for you, man.
Run around for hours going in the kitchen or in my bedroom, sitting in my bed.
Tell me you're not having a good birthday after that. And if you're not, I'll come there and smack your ass.
But hey, you one of my friends is in here. Miss Sabrina, that's one of my friends I invited last night to Eric's.
Oh, nice. Hey, hold on. I do have somebody that does want to hop on real quick, so let me let them on real quick, and then I'll let you right back on right after it. So give me just a minute here. Hey, Victor, what's up, man?
What's going on?
Hey, not too much. How you doing, man?
I'm doing good. How you doing?
Not too bad. What's going on with you, man?
I'm just hanging out with my boy Isaiah over here at Jackie's.
Oh, nice. That's what's up, man. That's what's up.
Yeah.
So how's your weekend going so far, man? Hey, yo, what up to everybody watching, man? Hey, Matthew, what's up, man? Hey, yo, Jasmine, what's up?
Huh?
How's your weekend going, man?
Good, how you doing?
Man, not too bad. You know, the usual, hanging out, working on music, working on artwork, kicking it with these guys. Same shit, different day.
That's true, man. That's true.
Hey, can't beat it, though, man.
Yeah, how's life up there?
I'm boring as
Boy, it's hot over here in Florida.
Right? Same here, dude. Don't feel bad. It's
like
hot.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, man. So how are things back there anyway? Because I haven't been there in like for fucking ever.
Ah, man, that's crazy. A lot of stuff going on over here.
Like what? What's going on?
A lot of school shootings and another person took out a couple lives and a video thing for the Madden video
really?
Game. Yeah, somebody killed somebody in Jacksonville. So yeah.
Oh my god, I didn't hear about that. That's crazy, dude.
It is crazy. And then we're getting ready for a new governor here in Florida.
Really?
Yeah. So our governor is going
really?
To the Senate.
When is that supposed to happen?
It's supposed to be next year.
Wow.
Yeah, it's
like I said, dude, I haven't been there in fucking years, so like, I'm not sure all too what's going on anymore.
Yeah, Florida's a little bit different, Mr. I think this is last year for Mr. Smith being at Job Coordinator.
Yeah, that's what he was. That's, as a matter of fact, last time I talked to him, that's what he was saying, is that this year coming up is going to be his last one. He's going to retire.
Yeah, I said, yeah, he's retiring this year. That's what his son told me. His son is my
principal. Like I said, dude, like, Mr. Smith, man, like, even you know, man, he's always been, you know, that father figure in my life ever since I was little. And to see him retire like that, like, it sucks.
It does. It does suck.
Because, like, that's the dude that whenever I did something bad, he was the dude right there jumping down my throat and kicking my ass every time. It never failed.
It never fails. It never fails at all.
So how's everybody back home doing anyway? Like, you still hear from any of the others, or what's up?
I talked to Danielle.
Coffee. Really? How's she doing?
Her and her husband is getting divorced.
Really? When did that Whoa, I didn't even know she was married. Dude, that's crazy.
She's married to that big guy, Coughlin, whatever his name it was. Albert.
No shit.
Albert. Yeah, she was married.
Wow. If y'all don't know, guys, this is one of my best friends right here growing up. This is Victor. I pretty much grew up with this dude since fucking, for how many fucking years, bro?
Man, I started going to Roosevelt when I was in 2001, and I graduated in 2005.
Right, so like, we've known each other since we were kids.
When we were kids, yeah.
So if y'all don't know me, I practically grew up with this crazy fucker right here.
Yeah, you have. Art Roosevelt's changing.
Oh, yeah, I've seen pictures and everything, dude. I'm like, holy shit, it's changed.
Yeah, it's changed. They put an AC unit in the gym. Yeah.
It's about damn fucking time.
It was hot.
It was, dude. Like, oh, my God. Like, I remember fucking going in there in Miss Kimbrough's fucking gym class and it being just super fucking hot.
You know,
I hate that
in the gym. They smell ranky.
Damn.
Yeah, they were ranky. When I went to the gym and played basketball with some of those kids, they didn't even put no deodorant on.
Dude, I fucking hated gym class because it was so fucking hot.
Yeah, it was just hot.
I didn't mind it, but some of the days, man, it was like, fuck.
Yeah.
Especially towards the end of the year when it got real hot, it's like, what are we even doing in here?
That's true.
Like, I fucking hated that class.
Yeah.
Now, I will admit, though, man, Mr. Cruz's ag class, man, that was cool as fuck. Like, you got to be outside in the cool air and everything, so, like, you weren't really hot.
Yeah, that's true. Hey, guess who I ran into the other day? Remember Jeremy Stokes?
Do what?
You remember Jeremy Stokes?
Oh my God! Yeah, how's he doing?
Oh, he's doing good. He's running. He's working for his. You know, his dad passed away a long time ago.
So really?
He took over his dad's business and for Little Debbie. Little Debbie's.
Oh wow!
Yeah, so he's doing Little Debbie's deliveries on the weekdays. And he got to live at his own lawn service on the weekends. He cuts grass and...
Oh, wow.
Yeah, he makes some killer money. He got kids and got some family.
Yeah.
He's doing good.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That is freaking awesome, dude. Like, it sucks to hear about his dad, but it's awesome to see that he's taking over and doing well for himself.
Yeah, he's doing better. I talked to him about if he was all right, because it's hard when you lose a loved one.
Oh yeah, it is, dude. Like, I've lost a lot of people. Like, my older brother, who I know you remember, my older brother. Like, he used to walk me to school sometimes and shit. Yeah. Like, he passed away back in 2016 from lung cancer and pneumonia combined, and then. Later on after that, Stefan passed away from that brain aneurysm, and that one shocked me. That Stefan's death definitely was a shocker, because me and him were literally talking that night before, saying how we need to catch up.
Yes.
And then to find out from his sister that he had died from a brain aneurysm, I'm like, oh my God, like he was doing just fine yesterday. Like, what the fuck happened?
Yeah, that's true.
Like, that shocked the fuck out of me. I was like, oh my God, like, I just talked to him that day before.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it was crazy, dude. Like, and to find that out, like, that sucked. I was like, oh my God, like, this is a dude, like, this is one of the dudes that I used to hang out with every fucking day. To see him pass away like that, that's sad.
Yeah, that's kind of crazy.
And there's a lot of people that we went to school with that have passed away, but that one right there definitely, I would, like, it was more or less unexpected.
Yes.
Like, that was the more unexpected one out of all the guys that we knew that had passed. Like, that was more the most unexpected, at least for me, anyway.
It was. Hey, did you see Crystal and Robbie got married?
Really?
Yeah.
When did she get married?
They got married not too long ago.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah, I was proud for those two. They deserved each other. You know what I mean? For the school.
Right.
When they went to
school. Right,
that's like
Rachel and Marcus, man. Like, we all went to school together, and to see those two end up together, and that was fucking awesome.
Yeah, it was. So I'm glad they are together, and they're doing well. You know, they're doing well.
Oh, yeah. Dude, I talked to Rachel and Marcus all the fucking time.
Yeah, they're doing good, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Like, dude, I'm always talking to Rachel and Marcus and shit. So, like, I'll be like, hey, what up, guys?
Yeah.
and that's the thing. Like, people don't realize that people like me and you and everybody that we went to school with, like, we're basically family to each other. We grew up together. We know each other.
Yeah, we do.
It's like... it's crazy, like, and you know, it is funny, like, thinking back then, I never would have thought that now, like, we would all still be as tight as we fucking are. I never would have guessed that.
Yeah.
Like, it's crazy, like, oh my God.
It is crazy.
And, like, and me and Stephanie, we did end back up together for a little bit, both her working and shit.
Yeah.
Like, as many hours as she works, like, it wasn't working out. So I was like, you know what, screw it, move on. As much as it sucks, you know, you do what you got to do.
That's true. That's true. Jackie says, she said, hey.
Hey, Jackie, what's up?
Okay, she's
good.
Hey, what's up?
What's up?
Hey, not too much. How you been?
Good.
That's good. Hey, I hear you work for a school now. That's freaking awesome.
Yep. 12 years.
Awesome. God, it's been too fucking long. Oh, my God. If y'all don't know, this is one of my best friends growing up. This is fucking Jackie. I went to school with these guys, all right? Oh, my God. It's been too many fucking years. Holy shit.
Yeah, it's true. You're right.
Dude,
about that.
Way too long.
Too long.
I'll show
yeah,
you.
So how you been? Like, what's going on with you?
Nothing much. Working in
Isaiah. That's my son Isaiah.
Hey, little dude, what's up?
This is our son.
This,
hi.
This is Jack. Yeah.
There's Jack.
What's up, little man? What's up? Hey. It's always jealous, obviously.
He's shy.
Somebody don't like the camera.
No, he don't like the camera. You don't like the camera?
Hey, I was, believe it or not, before I started doing this on a regular basis, I was the same way, so I get it. I used to be camera shy all the time, but now it's more or less, you kind of get used to it over time.
Maybe you just don't know you yet, Chance.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, that could be.
Yeah,
like, dude, that's awesome to see. Yeah, that's fucking awesome.
Yeah, it is.
My God, it's been too many fucking years.
I mean, it flew by quick, man. Can you believe
I'm by coming up? Do what?
My birthday's coming up. I turned 32.
Damn, dude, you're not that much older than me. I'm about to be freaking 28 here on the 20th.
Wow, man. You and Jackie the same age. Jackie's 28.
Damn, dude, I completely forgot about that. Holy shit, you're right.
Yeah. You probably went to class with Jackie.
Yeah.
Dude,
I remember those classes too, man. Like, those are some, not gonna lie, man, those are some pretty good classes.
Yeah, they were.
Now somebody just wants to fuck with you.
Yeah.
instead of being on camera, he wants to screw with you behind camera.
See?
Behind.
Hey.
Hey, what's up, little man?
I love climbing up stuff.
He loves climbing up on his daddy.
Hey, my niece is the same exact way. Like, she's only a couple months old, but she'll try to climb all over me, and I'm just like, really, child? You're only a couple months old. You're not supposed to be doing this yet.
You're only a couple months old,
and you're already trying to climb all over me and do shit. Like, come on now. Give me a break.
Me and Jackie got Isaiah one of those Nintendo Switch.
Oh, nice.
And he likes the dance one, the dance song.
Yeah. Oh, dude, Dance Dance Revolution, yes. Oh, my God.
You did the dance and you move. And...
Oh, yeah, I've played that. Like, dude, you're talking to a guy that had a Super Nintendo and N64 when he was a kid, so I know about that shit.
Yeah.
Come on, Doc.
Like, oh, my God. Man, the memories of freaking school, though, man. Holy shit.
Man, I talked about those memories yesterday to some of the teachers because I'm a janitor at Bartow High School.
Really?
Yeah. I'm a custodian, too. I've been as a school board for 4 years.
Damn.
Yeah, it's going off quick.
Oh, yeah. And I also heard about what happened in McLaughlin Middle School, man. That sucks.
Yeah.
The funny thing is, that's where I went to middle school at, was McLaughlin Middle School down there. So, like, to see it go from being an awesome school to what it is now, it's like, what happened?
Yeah, true.
Like, McLaughlin used to be a damn good school, and now it's like, what the hell happened to make it the way it is? Like, what the heck?
I don't know. See, I went to Boone Middle School in Hank City, and they changed a lot there.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff that changed, man. Like, I was in Florida visiting my dad back in 2014, and just seeing the general area was like, oh my God, it's changed. Like, granted, I still knew where everything was at, surprisingly, but at the same time, it's like, damn, like, memories.
Yeah, memories. Lots of memories.
Like, it was fun, though. Like, I mean, you know, like, even though me and him don't get along, we no longer speak because of how he is, you know, like, just going back down there and visiting with some of the guys and stuff that we grew up with was pretty freaking awesome.
Yes.
Like, it was funny. Like, I was at the lake, and I caught up with some of the guys that we used to go to school with, and, like, they didn't even recognize me at first. They're like, yeah, they kind of had to take that a second look, and they're like, dude, holy shit. Hey, what up, Becca?
2 days later. Oh, somebody talking to us when we're talking to each other?
Oh, no, I'm just, every time somebody pops in, I'm like, hey, what's up?
Oh, it pops on yours?
Oh, yeah. Somebody's having fun. Somebody's having fun with a train, that's what I see.
It sounds like a train, doesn't it?
He's got one of those train whistles, doesn't he?
No, he was blowing in the cup and it sounded like a train.
Do it again.
Do it again. Yeah. Do it.
Dude, that is super cool. I never heard that come out of a freaking gump like that. That is super cool.
Yes, it is.
It has M&M's inside of it.
M&M's inside of the cup.
That is super cool. Like, I mean, I've done, you know, stuff like with bottles and stuff like that, but to hear that, that's interesting. I never would have guessed.
Yeah.
That. Well, I'll have to try that. I'll have to try and use that in some of my stuff. That's like
Disney World or something. We got Disney. Yeah. Sounds like the train from Disney. You remember the train from Disney?
It does.
Yeah,
it does sound like it, dude. Like I said, I'll have to try that and use that sound in some of my stuff next time I work on some music. Like, I'll have to try that out and see how that works out. That is so cool.
Huh?
I was just saying, like, next time I work on a song, man, I'll have to try to get that sound and use that. That is super cool.
Yeah, that is cool. You can use that as a new song type.
Oh, yeah, definitely, dude. I have this weird thing where I can make weird sounds work with each other. It's weird.
Oh, wow.
But, dude, that is super dope, though. I like that. That is so cool.
That is cool.
How old is he, anyway?
Isaiah?
Yeah.
Isaiah 7.
Oh, wow. He looks like he should be older than that.
He does, don't he? I
know. He looks like he should be about 10. Like, it's crazy.
Yeah, he's a big kid.
He gets it from his mom and dad.
He gets it from my gym, his mama.
Dude, wait until he hits our age, man. He'll be freakishly tall.
Yeah, he will. He'll be like a tall person.
Yeah, dude. My cousin Cody, man, he's freaking in his 20s, and he's like 7 foot. So, like, I'm down here at 5'3". He's way up there, and I'm like, hi, how's the weather up there?
I dropped the phone.
Hey, you good?
I dropped the phone.
Hey, I do that all the time, man, so don't feel bad. But, yeah, like I was saying, dude, my cousin Cody, he's like 21, 22, and he's like 7 foot. So every time I talk to him or see him, I'm like, hi, how's the weather up there? Because I'm down here at 5'3". He's way up here towering over 7 foot. So I'm like literally stretching to look up at him. I'm like, hi. Hey, Drago, what's up, man? How you doing? But, dude, it's good to see you guys again, man. It's been way too freaking long, dude.
Yeah, it is. Good to see you, too. One of the teachers from Bartow High School, she goes to school with me. How are you doing? He's watching. He works with me at Bartow High School. Yeah.
Nice. Dude, I remember Bartow, man. Like, I never really actually went to high school there, but, like, I know the area. I've been through Bartow so many freaking times. I can't even count them all.
Yeah. I guess when we did the live feed, I guess it goes to everybody then.
Hey. That's probably because they see you talking to me and shit. I guarantee you, Give it a few minutes, man. I guarantee you a bunch of people that we know probably popped in from when we were kids.
Yeah.
Probably. Guaranteed.
So, I think that's what it is.
Probably either that or they're seeing that me and you are alive with each other, and they're just like, all right, what's up?
See, James Baggs is watching, too.
Dang, dude.
I got James Baggs watching. One of the guys that went to school with us at Roosevelt.
Hey, Quinn, what's up?
That's crazy, ain't it, man? Getting all these people.
Dude, I didn't, like, oh, my God. Like, I didn't think, like, this is just going to, like, oh, my God. This is going to be just a normal live stream. But, dude, this just went from normal to fucking awesome.
It is awesome, dude.
Like I said, man, I ain't seen you guys since I was a fucking kid, which was, that was probably about, last time I seen you guys was about 2007, 2008, when I moved from Florida right after the hurricanes, went to Maryland, went back down, and then came up here. So, like, damn, it's been a long time.
Yeah, it has. So, any bad weather up there?
Not right, surprisingly, not right now. It's actually nice out today.
Getting cool? Is it cool a little bit?
It's getting there slowly. I mean, we live right by Summit Lake down here in Akron, so like when it gets cold, it gets cold.
Up there, it does get cold.
Well, I mean, it's not just, it's not just your regular cold, but when it gets cold, you got to figure, we live literally a couple, not even 1,000 feet from the lake. So when it gets cold during the winter, you got that cold front coming up off the lake, and it makes it 100 times worse than what it is.
Yeah.
And it sucks. Oh, my God, does it suck.
I mean, we're supposed to get rain for the next 7 days.
That's why I don't go out during the wintertime out of town. I'm like, fuck that. I'm staying inside where it's warm. Fuck the cold.
Yeah.
Like, I'd rather be inside where it's warm and I'm not freezing my ass off.
Well, at least here in Florida, it never gets cold in the winter. It's always hot.
Yeah, you guys are lucky. You're lucky, man. It never gets cold there. You're lucky. Florida. Dude, you fuckers are lucky. It never gets cold there.
No, we don't get no cold weather here. We just get like warm and hurricanes.
Dude, hurricanes are dude, I swear to God, dude, Florida gets more hurricanes than God knows what. It's crazy.
I mean, we had a hurricane that hit us. I was getting close. 2010. No, it was last year. It was September 10th. Irma, it slammed in. Yeah.
Yeah, I remember Irma. Seeing that on the news. That's why when they were showing it on the news, I'm like, oh shit! Like, I know way too many people down there. I hope everybody's all right.
Yeah, man.
Like, dude, I remember Hurricane Charlie too, man. Hurricane Charlie was some mean shit.
Yeah.
Hurricane Charlie was that was definitely a mean ass hurricane, not gonna lie. That was pretty brutal.
But the other two hurricanes that went behind Charlie and coming straight across Florida, too much.
Dude, surprise, believe it or not, I actually still have on DVD because my older brother, before he had passed away, he had actually made a DVD of all the stuff that went on during that time. So now, like, I watch back. I watch it sometimes. And I'm just like, I remember that area. Like, I remember all this going on. I was there.
Wow, dude. Wow.
And, like, and just looking back, I'm just like, damn, like, to think how brutal it got back then. It was bad. Like, dude, I remember just driving down the street by the freaking orange groves, and you got, like, the little tiny-ass ones, and they're all, like, all the tiny fucking trees are just, like, all bent over, pointed in one direction. I'm just like, damn.
I mean, you seen how bad the power poles was laying on the ground over there in Hank City?
Oh, yeah. I remember that shit. Hey, what's up, James?
Landed them on the ground, like, left and right. Boom, 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 boom. Dude,
that's like Uncle Joe's fish camp where I grew up half my life in Florida at Uncle Joe's fish camp. Like, dude, the freaking trees that came down there, oh my God, it was nasty, dude. Like, it took a pretty good year to get that one tree that fell in between Adam's house and Adam's house cleared out. Like, it sucked.
Yeah, it was. James on the back said, what's up?
I know, I seen him. What's going on, man?
Did you see him?
Yeah, I've seen it.
Okay. Yeah, I've seen it across my screen.
Yeah. But, dude, during Hurricane Charlie, man, that was some mean shit. Not gonna lie, man. Charlie was probably one of the worst ones I think we've had when I was down there.
Yeah, it was, man.
Like, it was, that was some brutal stuff.
It was.
So, like, who all is still, like, working at the school? Like, who all is still working at Roosevelt?
Most of the, there's almost half of the staff we know who was still at Roosevelt. I know that.
Still, dang, dude. That's crazy.
It is.
Like, dude, I remember, like, when we were kids, like, I remember going there and just, like, and all the teachers knew who I was. Like, all the staff knew me. So, like, I could go in there every day, like, every single one of them would be like, hey, what's up?
I know Miss Bagby and Mr. Bagby still there.
Really?
Yeah, I know they still do. They're...
They still doing the barbecue thing or what?
Yeah, they still do it. Yep.
Still? Dude, that's awesome.
Yeah, it is.
And dude, Mr. I like that pork, man. I mess with that pork they do every year, man.
Yeah. And I heard Miss Harris is still there too.
Really?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Mm-hmm.
Damn, dude, that's awesome though. I guarantee you I could go back there now and every single one of them will still recognize me. Guaranteed.
Yeah, I think they would too. Because most of my friends,
like, I haven't really changed that much. I mean, I've gotten, you know, a little bit taller. Lost hair on top of my head a little bit. Other than that, haven't changed a fucking bit.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up, Greg? How you doing, man? But, yeah, dude, that's awesome to see. That's awesome, though, man, to see all the staff that we grew up with still be in there. Like, that's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah,
like, I know that Mr. Smith went from doing the job stuff to doing, I think it was like disciplinary or some weird stuff like that.
I know he still does the job coordination for us, you know, if we need any help, he's still there.
Yeah.
To help.
Yeah.
Was you there when Miss Brown was there?
Yeah.
You know, she's at Bartow High School?
Really? When did she go from where? When did she go from Roosevelt to Bartow?
Yeah. Yeah, she's a teacher.
When did she go from, like, what year did she go from Bartow to, or from Roosevelt to Bartow? Like, when did that happen?
I don't know, but she was, when I got hired with Bartow, she wasn't there, but I think it was the one before, the before after.
Huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, because like I said, I left there in 2008, 2007-ish. So, like, it had to be within that time period.
I'll talk to her and let her, find out when she got hired over there. But I think it was 2015, 2016. I think she started making
teachers.
Yeah.
What about Mr. Reiser? Is he still there or did he retire?
I don't remember.
Like, I know that, like, some are saying that he's still there, some are saying that he retired, so it's like, I don't know.
Yeah.
I mean, he could still be there. Maybe he's planning on retiring. I don't know.
Yeah, that's true.
But, I mean, like I said, dude, like, it's been so many freaking years since I've been there. Like, I don't know who's doing what no more. Like, who's there, who's not there. Like, it's crazy.
Yeah, they changed the color. I drove by there the other day. It's not like a pinkish color at Roosevelt anymore.
Really? What did they change it to?
Brown.
Ah, hey, it works.
Yeah, it's a brown color. Yeah, it's a brown color, and they still got that sign that we helped build for Mr. Smith.
Oh, nice. They still got that, huh?
They still got the Roosevelt sign.
Nice.
Yeah, I went over there.
What about the uniform? They still do the same color uniforms they had when we were kids, or what?
I think they changed them up a little bit.
Really?
I'm not sure. Yeah.
Dude, that's crazy. Believe it or not, I still do have the camo one that they had when we were kids. Like, I still actually have a couple of the shirts.
I still got one too. I still got it with all your names and everything on it.
Nice.
Yeah, I saved it.
That's what's up, dude. Like, and it's funny, like every time I wear the camo uniform, they're like, "Dude, you get a Roosevelt?" I'm like, "Yeah, I used to."
Yeah. What are you doing?
But like, man, holy crap, dude. Oh my god, yo! All right, hold up. Give me 1 minute, man. I'll be right back.
Yeah, it is.
Boom.
Oh, you sure do got it. There you go.
Classic, man.
Does it got the eagle on the back?
And it still fits, too, surprisingly.
Does it got the eagle on the back?
Do what?
It got anything on
the
back?
No, this is like right after when they did the camo ones without the eagle on the back.
Oh, yeah.
Without the eagle on it. Because you had these ones, you had the blue ones that had the eagle on it, and then you had the two different black ones.
Yeah, I remember that.
Like, I remember, man, at one point, like, I don't hate it so much now, but back then, it's like, I hated the dress code.
Oh, man, dress codes, when they told us we couldn't even wear the shirts like we loved to used to wear, we had to go to the dress code situation. I didn't like it. I didn't like it at all.
Oh, I hated the dress code, man. Like, I hated the fact that, like, you couldn't, like, have your shirt how you wanted it. Like, you couldn't, like, have it untucked. It had to be tucked in. I'm like, do you have any idea how annoying that is?
Yeah, it is.
Like, dude, that got so annoying. Like, I mean, I know they did it for a reason, but it's like back then you're just like, oh, why me? I hated the dress code. Like, oh, man, like, I love the school to death. Don't get me wrong. I mean, Roosevelt will always be a second home to me, but the dress code, man, no.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, get me away from the dress code, please. That's why I like doing what I do now with my artwork, my music, stuff like that. I don't have to worry about, dress code. I can wear whatever the hell I want and get away with it.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, hell, if I want to wear a freaking pink hat with what I wear, I can do it. Not that I own any, just saying. You could have fixed it with a pen. Maybe you should take that pen. Oh, man, well, it's good to see you guys are doing good, man. It's great to see you guys after all these freaking years.
Yeah, it's good, man. Good to see you, too.
Oh, my God.
Were you playing the guitar earlier?
Do what?
Was you playing the guitar?
Yeah, it was a little bit ago, actually.
You were doing pretty good, actually.
And believe it or not, I do still have that other one that I had when I was down there. I do still have it.
Do you?
Hey, let me go grab it real quick. I'll show you what I mean.
All right.
Even though the neck's kind of busted on it a little bit.
Oh, wow. That's nice, dude.
Yeah, even like as you can tell over the years from the wear on it, the neck's kind of busted off right there, but still playable. I just got to adjust the strings on it a little bit, but other than that, just still got it.
Got it going on.
Oh yeah, and then I got that one, and I got this full size one right here.
Oh, there you go, right there.
And the funny thing is, I didn't know this, but a friend of mine from high school, he actually gave this to me. And on the back, I didn't notice till I got home, but he did that on the back.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah, he free-handed that whole thing. I was like, what? Dude, that's crazy.
It is crazy.
Like, I didn't even know that he had done that until I got home and looked at the back. I was like, holy shit, that's awesome.
Yeah.
But yeah, dude, I've been, like, ever since I got that guitar that I had since I was a kid, man, I've just been learning how to do it on my own, kind of teaching myself everything I know now with artwork, music, kind of basically learned everything I know on my own music-wise. Like, I didn't have anybody to teach me. I just kind of naturally picked it up and went from there.
That's true, man.
Oh my god, dude, the years have gone. It's one of those scenes where now it's just like we're both sitting here like, where'd the years go?
This one about quit, man. I graduated in 2005.
Dang, dude, that's right, you did. Because like I remember I had just gotten there and you had just graduated that year before.
Yeah.
Damn, it's been a long time. Yeah. Shit.
When I graduated, Miss Glockner left, and then
yeah,
Miss Pembroke left after that. Not, what's her name? What the one lady at the gym?
Yeah, Miss Kimbrough.
Miss Kimbrough, yeah, she left too.
Really? When did she leave?
After I think after I graduated.
Wow.
Well, Glockner did. Miss Glockner.
Wow.
Yeah.
Dude, that's crazy. Like, I remember gym class with Miss Kimbrough, dude. Like, she, oh my god, she was strict. Oh my god.
Well, she was strict. You know, you just had to, you know, follow her rules because, you know, she's been a teacher since my mom was going to school.
Oh yeah, like it's crazy, dude. Like when I was going there, like it was pretty easy going when we were going there, but like you know, like nowadays, like kids don't get, and that's the sad thing. Like kids nowadays, they don't get how easy they have it. Like when we went to school, it was not easy at all. Now,
these kids these days, they can walk all over you, but they. You know, we had a
right like now, dude. We got, dude. I remember when we were kids, man. I used to get my ass beat for trying to do that shit.
Yeah, my mom.
I remember getting my ass whooped as a kid growing up.
Truly, we got in trouble at school. I would get my butt whooped by my stepdad.
Oh, whenever I got in trouble at school, I not only got in trouble at school, but then when I got home, I got it even worse when I got home.
Yep. So that's why that's why I don't want to get myself in trouble.
Right. Like, dude, I remember all the times I got, man. And, you know, I swear to God, I lived in ISS half the time because of everybody screwing with me and shit and me having to fight back. Like, I remember ISS, dude, and oh, my God. It stuck. It straight up stuck, not going to lie. I fucking hated it.
Yeah.
But, like, nowadays, man, it's sad that the new generation of kids that are there and in general, like, they can get away with so much. And it's like, dude, if you tried doing this shit when you were my age, dude, you would have gotten your ass whipped.
Yeah, true.
Like, you would have gotten your ass handed to you. If we tried half the shit these kids tried, oh, my God, dude. I wouldn't even be here right now. I'd be 6 feet under dead right now.
You are that?
Like, oh my god.
Oh, there it goes.
What happened?
I don't know, but My name's popping up on the video. See it?
Yeah. That's cool. I still see, man. You're still talking. I still see your face and everything.
Oh, wow.
And you just switched the camera on. There you go.
That's cool. You can take your it looks like you can take your video off of there. Yeah, you can. They'll talk to you. Huh. I didn't know that.
But dude, that's sad to see what this new generation of kids is doing down there these days. Like, that's sad.
Yeah, it is, man.
Like, dude, I remember back when we were kids, we didn't have half the shit these kids have, man. We didn't have, we had cell phones at least, you know. I mean, we all had cell phones as kids. I mean, you were always able to text somebody. But, like, we weren't glued into them like this new generation is. Like, we didn't have freaking smartphones, Xbox Ones. Like, we didn't have any of that.
No, we had to earn it. We had to earn it before we got it. Dude,
Facebook didn't even exist yet.
Yeah. We had to earn that.
Dude, times were simpler back when we were kids. They really were. And now it's just like, what the heck?
Yeah, it was.
It's like, what happened in the old days when we were kids? What happened to shit being simple?
Just all changed, man.
Like, dude, I remember I remember going to school so many times with a fucking CD player attached to my hip, listening to music, like, every day. Like, oh my god. Those were the days, man, when you could walk around with a Walkman and not get bitched at.
Yeah, it was.
But now, like, everything's changed so much. It's like, what happened to being a normal kid and going outside and getting dirty? What happened?
I don't know.
Like, it sucks, dude. Like, I remember going outside, getting dirty, having fun, climbing trees, being a normal kid.
Everything's changed, man.
Right, and it's sad, dude. It really is. Oh my god. There you go, man. I'm about to end this live stream. It was definitely good catching up with you, man. It's been way too long.
No, it has been. It has been way too long.
Man, you guys take it easy, man. And hey, let everybody know I said hey whenever you see him.
Okay, I will.
Hey, y'all, if y'all don't know, I've known this dude since we were kids. So make sure you hit him up, say what's up. And thank you to everybody that's been watching, man. And hey, it was good having you on here, dude. As always, man. Love catching up, man. Definitely caught up on some old times. That was definitely fun.
It was good times, man. Hey, I don't know if anybody heard this on the radio yesterday. Sheriff Grady's judge said on the radio on 97.5, if you make a threat at a school, your butt is going to jail. Yep,
damn, right. It's about damn time, dude. It's about damn time they put that into place.
They passed a law here in the state of Florida. If you make a threat to another kid at school, you will go to jail. Yep,
about freaking time, man.
I heard that on the radio station yesterday.
That is awesome, dude. I'm glad to hear it. Like, damn, like, that's good.
And he said to all the parents out there to make sure you talk to your kids, because you did not want your kids to go to jail for making threats to another student.
No, and to the kids out there that are thinking about it, trust me, dude, jail is not what you want. No. Been there once myself. Trust me, you do not need that shit. It is the worst ever. So
it is.
Whatever you do, do not do it. Please, like he said, you know, talk to your kids and make sure they don't do anything stupid. You know, just common sense.
I don't want to sit down and talk to mine when he gets that age. You know, we don't want to put our kids in jeopardy and something like that, and they don't want to see a jail.
Oh, yeah. Like I said, it's all about common sense.
Yes.
which sadly this generation of kids lacked.
Yeah.
A lot of these kids lack common sense these days, and it's sad, man. It really is.
It is sad. It's sad.
Oh, man. Hey, it was definitely good catching up with you guys. Like, it's been, like I said, dude, it's been way too many years, dude. Like, it was definitely, like, it definitely went from being a normal live stream to something awesome, man. It was definitely cool as hell.
Yeah, this was pretty cool to get the chance to talk to you. I see you on here, but I didn't really get the chance to talk to you. And
like I said, dude, it's been God knows how many years since we freaking caught up. So it was definitely awesome to do that, man.
Yeah,
and thank you guys to everybody that watched, man. Freaking love you guys. You guys are amazing.
I'm here in Florida. He's up there. Where you at? Where are you located at?
Ohio.
Ohio, yep. So it's good to...
Yeah, so not too far.
No, it's not too far. I'm in the hot state.
And I'm in the cold state. Go figure, right?
Yeah. So.
But, y'all, I'm about to hop off here, kick it, and chill out. Might work on some new stuff for you guys. If you guys do not remember, I do have that contest coming up later on where y'all can win some stuff later on today. So that will be going on. But until then, I will see you guys later. It's been nice catching up with you, dude. Definitely keep in touch, man. Definitely message me, like, whenever, dude. Like, I'm always – you can get a hold of me 24/7 anytime.
All right, man.
All right. Man, I will catch you later. I will see you crazy fuckers that have been watching this later on. I'm out of here, man. Peace.
Later.
Later, man.